to my channel once again. This is your man Alam, and in today's tutorial we shall continue with the Microsoft Excel. This is the part 4 of the Excel tutorial, and in this tutorial we shall look at how we can code our Excel for our student report. You have done your student report, you want to score them based on their performance. You have gotten the class test, you have gotten the exercise in the assignment, you want to get their total, and you want to get their subtotal, round it to 40% and get the exam score, round it to 60%, get the total. You also want to grade it and give them the position on the remarks. So how do we do that? So this tutorial will help us to do that very quickly. And so without wasting my time, let's dive into it and then go. Now I will want to center the student report. So if you want to center it, just highlight the student report and then you merge and center, then everything will be there for you. But it has merged and centered up to D. So if I wanted to affect the whole thing, it means that I have to highlight and merge up to M. Okay, and then you merge and center and see what happened. It has come to that hole. Now I want to rename the sheet 1-2 to student report. So you double click on it and you now write report. I just want to write only report. Then you press enter. So I have now been able to adjust whatever I want to do. Let's go in and then look at the total score for each of the students. John, total score for all the assignments and then the exercise in the class test. So before you start with any formula in the Microsoft Excel, you have to start with an equal sign. So I start with an equal sign. I want to sum his total score. So sum, I'm summing from cell B3 to E3. That is for John. His class test, he has 13. Class test 1, he has 13. Class test 2, he has 20. Exercise, he has 9 out of 10. Then assignment, he has 14 out of 15. So after you have selected it, you press enter. So it means that he has 56 out of the total, which is 65. Now I'll autofill it. In the autofilling, you bring your mouse cursor to the right corner and you make sure it is changed to this sign. This sign means that you want to highlight it. In my first video, we have looked at how the mouse cursor positioning and all that. So this is highlight. When it is like this, it means you want to move it. Okay, this is move. But when it's like this, it means autofill. So let's autofill it to get all of them. So this helps you to do, you don't waste much time in your calculation. So quickly, we have gotten the total for all of them. Now let's get the subtotal. The subtotal is, I want to convert all of them to 40% such that I can get the exam score and convert the exam score to 60% and now add them to get the 100% I'm looking for. So with that, you press equal sign, then bracket open, cell F3 divides. So the way, the same way you deal with mathematics, just do that. So divide 65, bracket close. Now this is multiplying by, the multiplication sign is the star, multiply by 40, then you press the enter. So it means the person has, John has 34. You can round it to 34.5 and all that. Now I autofill that one too, and I have this. Okay, so with the exam score, I want to round it to 60% such that when I combine the total for all the exercises or the classwork, that is converted to 40 to the 60, I'll get 100. Then I can use that to run, to rank and then to give the position and then my remarks. So let's see how I can do that. So we start with the equal sign again. Then here we can also use the bracket open 68 over, so that's cell H3 over 100 multiplied by 60. Now you press enter. So it means the person has, John had 48.8% in the exam when you want to convert to 60. Now let me correct something here. If you don't use the H, that's the cell name, and you just type the figure there, 68, and you enter, you have the answer correct, but when I autofill it, it will repeat itself. It means it's not going to autofill, all right? So that is why we need to use the cell name, okay? Make sure the cell name is what you use, and you press the enter, and here we can autofill it to get the rest. Okay, so let's don't make that mistake. Now I can also do it this way. I know that 60% is 60 out of 100, which is the same as 0.6. So I can just say cell H3 multiplied by 0.6 and you enter, and it's still going to give the same result. Okay, so depending on how you want to manipulate it, the formula you learned in your mathematics is the same formula you are coming to apply. Just know how to use it and you are good to go. Now let's get the totals for all of them, the total for the exercises and then the class work together with the exam. So you get equal sign sum. I want to sum this cell, bracket open, don't forget to put the bracket open. So I want to sum this cell and then this cell together, okay? And then you press enter. Autofill it. You have got the total. So if you just press control and you click on this one and you click on the other one over here, the one that you want to sum, and then it will pinpoint them for you. Let me repeat it. I want to sum this. So you can type it inside. If I want to sum this, jump to the next one, jump to this. So you can type and put comma and jump. Or just press down control. Just press down control and you click on those that you want to sum. Okay, I want to sum these two, and that is all. Then you press enter, and that is what I did. Then you, sorry, I was moving it. Then you autofill it. All right, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification button so you'll not be left out when I release any other new video. And so in the next tutorial, we shall look at how to put the grading, the position, and the remarks. So until then, have a blessed time.